Hello everyone and welcome back to the United Star. I am Atanu Vadva and Manchester United have just won in the County Cup against Durham on penalties. In the regular time the scoreline was 2-2 but in the penalties United managed to win 5-3. Honestly speaking, mixed reviews of the game. First of all, starting with the starting 11. Aoife Mannion was the captain, and as you all know, Aoife Mannion is my favorite player, so I was very happy that Mannion got to captain in this game. So I think that makes it clear that she's one of the leaders. She is one of the contenders for the armband, so possibly she's the vice captain. We didn't see Mary Earps play, so maybe she's the vice captain, but like in my opinion, I think Katie Zellem, Mary Earps and Aoife Mannion are in the leadership group. Of course, there are other leaders on the pitch, but I'm talking with respect to the armband. But Aoife Mannion wearing the captain's armband. Honestly, I was dancing. I was really happy. And, well, what can I tell you? She did really well today as well. Of course, we conceded 2 goals. But I think that's something that we need to work on the training pitch. We need to, you know, do better in the set pieces. In the last few games we saw, we didn't actually concede in the set pieces. But today we conceded 2 goals from set pieces. So, of course, it hurts. But coming to our goal scorers, Ivana Fuso, amazing goal. I'm really happy for her. Actually, I predicted on my own Twitter account that Ivana Ferreira Fuso will score today. And well, she scored, so my prediction was right. And what can I say? I have mixed reviews of this game. Of course, Ivana Fuso was amazing. The goal that she scored was amazing, and the celebration that she did was also amazing with Maria Thore's daughter. And I think it was Wilde Borisa, Hannah Blundell also joined. So I think amazing goal, amazing celebration. First game for Ivana Fuso starting. First start for Manchester United for Ivana Fuso. She scored in that. And first start for Carrie Jones. She assisted Ivana Fuso for that goal. So of course, amazing, amazing, amazing. And you know, in the second half, Ivana Fuso was injured and it looks like a hamstring injury. Might be a knee injury, but I don't really know. She was down for 2-3 minutes on the ground. I think for a minute, I thought for a minute that she might be back. But as it stands, it's a bad injury. She was replaced by Ella Toon on the pitch, who was our second goal scorer. Ella Toon is on fire. Toon is on fire. Your defense is terrified. Toon is on fire. Another wonderful goal. From outside the box, Hayley Ladd with the assist. Ella Toon is, what can I say? Whatever praise that fans give to Ella Toon, or you know, fans applaud Ella Toon, it isn't enough, because the way she's been performing this season, she's on fire. I think I actually don't really know the exact numbers, but she has been involved in 6 or 7 goal contributions in this season for United. Amazing performance by Ella Toon. She also scored in the penalty shootout, so that helps. Aoife Mannion also scored in the penalty shootout. So did Alessia Russo, Hayley Ladd, Ella Toon. Hayley Ladd, Ella Toon, Alessia Russo, Wilde Borisa, and Aoife Mannion. So 5 players, we scored all of them. And well, Ella Toon was on fire. I think she like I said, she's played in 5 games for United, 6 games actually, and she scored 2 or 3 goals and has been involved in 4 or 5 assists. So that are outrageous numbers. She is our number 7, and I am really happy that she is playing for our team. Of course, she is a United academy product, and she is a Manchester United fan through and through. So of course I'm really happy for Ella Toon. So for the viewers, I wanted to tell that even though United won, but United won on penalties, So there's this rule in the Conti Cup, if you win on penalties, you won't be given 3 points, you will be given 2 points. And Durham was given 1 point because they like the loser of the penalty shootouts get 1 point and the winner gets 2 points. So sort of a weird rule. I don't know why. So amazing performance overall, but I think we conceded from set pieces, and that's something that we need to work upon. Maybe Eric Ramsey from the men's team comes in and does something. Yeah, we need to improve. And today I won't actually, go after Mark Skinner or any particular player. I think as a whole collective unit, we didn't manage to get that one more point. First goal, I think first goal was from a corner, and the second goal was from the edge of the box on the left-hand side when Healy lad committed a foul and Durham were given a free kick. And I think they scored the equalizer, the second equalizer from direct free kick goal. So kudos to Durham. But as you guys might remember in the preview of the Durham game, when Andy from All Four United WFC was on, he also said there's a bit of a rivalry between Durham and Manchester United. I think this game was good. We saw Ioana Ferreira Fuso, we saw Carrie Jones, and I think to some extent we won on penalties that might, take away the credit from Ioana Fuso and Carrie Jones, because let me be honest, they were amazing. They were amazing in the first half, I think in the second half as well, but we didn't actually get to see much of Carrie Jones and Ioana Fuso in the second half. Ioana Fuso especially, she can play from the middle, she can play on the wings. Her pace is really good. Her work rate on the pitch is really good. Her dribbling is really good, and she scored a goal on her first start for United. Carrie Jones, on the other hand, is Ella Toon 2.0. I have talked to many fans on Twitter, and I've talked to many fans on YouTube, and whoever knows Carrie Jones, they will draw this comparison between Ella Toon and Carrie Jones. So I think that's fair, because not that Carrie Jones is an Ella Toon, I think Carrie Jones is Carrie Jones, but we see glimpses of Ella Toon's brilliance in Carrie Jones. So that's something I really like. I know we shouldn't be drawing comparisons or, differences between players, but at the same time, I think for the viewers, I need to paint a picture, and I think the best way I can define Carrie Jones is she can play on the wings, she can play down the middle, she can play up front. So Ella Toon 2.0. And well, there is a certain anecdote that I got from my friends who have gone to who had gone to the game. Andy and Connor had gone to the game. They both are from All Four United WFC, and they told us that Mark Skinner, initially flags weren't allowed. Whenever you watch Manchester United women's play at the LSV or any other stadium, you see these flags. Kirsty Hansen, Bamiyami, Mark Skinner's Bamiyami, she's magic, always believe in Russo. So every player has a flag. So the United fan base, or the MUWSC and the All For United WFC, actually carry these flags. But today in the Durham Stadium, they weren't allowed to put flags, and that's something that really upsetted a lot of fans. And Mark Skinner also got to know about it. So he told MUTV before the game begun that if we win, like when we win, he'll pick up a flag and raise it, and carry it around on the pitch after the full time whistle. And that's something that he really did. We'll be sharing the photos on Twitter, on our Twitter account, and we'll be retweeting some from the fans who were there. So Mark Skinner's Bamiyami. He's our gaffer. I totally back him. I know there might be some times that I might criticize him, but that's something because I know what he's capable of. I know he's a really good manager. People might say he didn't have the best of tenures at Orlando Pride, but at the same time, I believe in him. I trust my manager. I trust Mark Skinner to do well. I know Mark Skinner can take this side ahead and, do some unique things. I know Casey Stoney also did really well with this side, but we are in a new era. We are in the Mark Skinner era, and I think he has what it takes to do well. Just a few tweaks, increasing the depth up front, Some players are injured right now, so of course that makes it a bit more difficult. I think he uses this word sustainable development. He uses the word connections, and that's something I really like because I know people might say, okay, we win this game, we won against Durham, but in the next game if we lose, that won't be sustainable development, and that's something Mark Skinner is working on. Even if we drew against Manchester Derby today, we saw a fighting spirit from the United players, which I think to some extent was missing against Manchester in the Manchester Derby. But today we saw that fighting spirit, so I'm really happy. So 2 points for United in the Conti Cup. They are second right now. Only the top, only the top, the top teams from every group will qualify, and the best runners-up team. So from all the groups, they'll compare, and I think they'll draw a points per game chart, and according to that, the team that comes on the top of the points per game chart in the runners-up table, they'll go ahead and will be joined by Chelsea and Arsenal, who are in the UWCL group stages, so they get a bye in the group stages of Conti Cup. So it's very messy. If you really want to talk about the rules, you can always DM me on Twitter, or you can always reach out to the United Star on our Instagram or Twitter, or maybe email, or maybe drop down a question below in the comment section and I'll be happy to answer it. So 2 points for United, 2 goals by Ivanafuso, 1 goal by Ivanafuso, 1 goal by Elatoon, 5 goals in the penalty shootout by Elatoon, Hayley Ladd, Aoife Mannion, Wilde Borisa, and Alessia Russo. That's it. That's the review of my game. I just wanted to state that the international break will start now. So people might think, okay, Atano won't come out, the United Star won't come out with more content about the women's team. But I have some things planned in my head. Hopefully, we'll implement them and keep you updated about the women's team as and when the videos get uploaded. So don't miss out on our videos. The men's international break has ended, and we'll be out with the watch-alongs, the previews, the reviews, and the discussions on the StarCast podcast that we have on our YouTube channel. So stay tuned. We are the United Star. Do subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you next time.